Everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to be sharing a few things that I am loving right now. I have a bunch of random things. I do have some makeup to share, but I also have some skincare, some fragrance, and just a few random things that I've been loving that I really wanted to share with you. If you're new here, my name is Blair. I do all kinds of beauty and makeup content here on YouTube every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. But I am posting every day in December. I hope you'll stick around and subscribe. I would love to have you here on my channel. And let's go ahead and get into everything that I'm loving right now. The first thing that I wanted to share with you is the fragrance that I've been wearing. I've shared it a few times in the last few months here on my channel, and they are from Dossier. This portion of the video is in collaboration with Dossier. If you're not familiar with them, they are a company that produces luxury-inspired fragrances at a much more affordable price point. They have tons of fragrances to choose from, and they're all inspired by some of the most popular luxury fragrances that typically cost a few hundred dollars for a bottle. Their prices range anywhere from $29 to around $50, which is incredible. And I have a few new ones that I've been using. The first one I wanted to share is actually this one. It's called Floriental Vanilla. This is actually inspired by YSL's Black Opium, which I had actually never smelled that fragrance myself, but it got really good reviews on the website and I decided to try it out, and I really like this. I don't have anything that smells like this. They include the notes of the fragrance on the top here. The top notes of this are mandarin, pear, pink pepper, and licorice, which is not typically something I would think that I would like. But I really like it. It's very different for me. It's a little bit sweet, obviously, from the vanilla, but it also has a little bit of floral scent to it. Like, the middle note is jasmine and orange blossom, so I guess maybe that's where I'm getting the floral scent from. I don't know, but it kind of reminds me of winter. It's a very warm, like, comforting smell. I really like it. I've been wearing this one quite a bit since I got it. And the other one that I've been wearing a ton is actually this one. So this is called Musky Musk. And this was inspired by Julia Azzagun. Now, I can attest to this, that this smells identical to Julia Azzagun, because I own Julia Azzagun. I bought it sometime, I think it was in 2020 I bought it. And I have it. I love it. I'm not kidding you, this smells just like it, and it's less than half the price. So this one is very interesting. If you've ever smelled Julia Azzagun, you'll know what I mean. It doesn't have many notes at all, but I think it's a very woodsy, almost masculine smell, which I've talked about before. I really like that, especially this time of year. I don't know what it is. It smells very clean and woodsy to me, which I really like, and I love that this smells exactly like the original, and it truly does. One of the things that I love about Dossier, besides the really affordable price point, is they actually send you a mini fragrance sample with your order, so you can smell the fragrance with the sample first, and then if you don't like it for whatever reason, you can always send it back, and that way you didn't open the full size, which I think is really brilliant, because sometimes you just don't know if you're gonna like a fragrance if you've never smelled it. Even if you know notes that you typically like, sometimes you really just have to smell things, because a lot of times fragrances smell different on different people. So you kind of need to know exactly how something smells on you to determine if you like it or not. So that's something I really love about them, and they're always adding new fragrances to the website as well. If you're interested in checking out Dossier, I will list my code and the link below in my description box. And thank you so much to Dossier for partnering with me again on this portion of the video. So next, I wanted to share the jewelry that I'm wearing. I share jewelry a few times here on my channel, and I recently got a few pieces from Ana Luisa. They did send them to me. This video is not sponsored by them, but I wanted to share these two specific pieces again because I have pretty much worn them every day since I got them. You've probably seen them several times in my last few videos, but this chain is called the Ina necklace, and it's just a really simple gold herringbone chain. It's one of the flat chains. I think they're called herringbone chains, but this one is called the Ina, and it is from Ana Luisa. So they are a sustainable jewelry company based in New York, and they also sent me these Paris hoops. I'll take them out so you can see. They're very tiny and dainty, but they're very heavy. I was very surprised how heavy they were when I got them. And they're kind of that croissant, or they kind of remind me of the croissant jewelry trend that was kind of going around. They're just a twisted hoop, but I just feel like they go with everything. I mean, I'm not kidding you. I've literally worn these every day since I got them. I love them so much. And you guys know I always have these little gold hoops in. I never take them out. I have a gold ball on this side, little diamond stud on this side. I always have gold rings on, and usually I have more than one necklace on, but today I just have this one. This is so perfect for any outfit, literally. Yesterday I just had on a t-shirt and leggings. I had on this necklace. Today I have on this really just a plain cream color long sleeve top, and I have this on, and I feel like it just kind of makes me look like my outfit is a little more special, you know, than it actually is. I wanted to share my jewelry with you because number one, I get a lot of people asking me about jewelry, and number two, it's just something I always wear. You guys see me in gold jewelry in every single video. Literally. So I'm always looking to try out new pieces, and I wanted to share this with you because I've really been loving the earrings and the necklace and wanted to share it. All right, let's talk about a few skincare items that I've been using and really loving that I wanted to share. The first one is from First Aid Beauty, and it's the Ultra Repair Cream. So this, I think, is like a cult favorite product of theirs. I got mine few months ago. Well, I guess it's been like 6 months now, but it's a very thick cream. I don't know if you're gonna be able to tell. This is the jar. This is 6 ounces of product you get in here. I think it retails for $36. I got this because I like to use something really thick at nighttime, particularly this time of year, because I don't have super dry skin, but I definitely can have a bit of dryness and irritation if I don't apply something really moisturizing before I go to bed, particularly like around my mouth area. And I started using this, and I don't know what it is in here, but my skin really likes this. I even applied this today before makeup. It lays really well under products, under my sunscreen. I haven't had any issues with it. I'm not sure what it is that my skin seems to like because it has a lot of good ingredients in it. I know one of the main things is colloidal oatmeal, which I don't really know. I know oatmeal and oat is supposed to be soothing for your skin, so I don't know if that's what it is, but it also has licorice root extract, which I know is also very calming for your skin, and then it also has shea butter in it, which kind of gives it that thick texture that I really like. I did want to say it has a scent, and it smells like eucalyptus. It's not overpowering. I was looking in the ingredients list, and eucalyptus is listed last on the ingredient list, which means there's the least amount of that ingredient in the product. And I did want to point it out though, because I was a little worried about that when I first got it, because typically I like to stay away from things that have fragrance in them, but for some reason, this really agrees with my skin. My skin feels really good when I put this on at night or even in the day, but I've typically been using it at night. You can also put this, obviously, anywhere else on your body, but I've primarily been using it on my face. So if you like more of a thick nighttime moisturizer, and you have more sensitive skin like I do, I would definitely recommend looking into this. You guys know if you watch my videos, my skin is definitely on the sensitive side, but it's pretty normal. So I wouldn't say that it's super dry or super oily. It definitely has a bit of a tendency to be dry this time of year, but my skin is pretty normal. It's just very sensitive. So I wanted to mention this moisturizer because I've been using this a ton. All right, and then another skincare item I wanted to share. I can't remember if I've ever shared this on YouTube before, but if you have an issue with any extreme dryness, like I'm talking dry lips, dry hands, dry elbows, anything that's extremely dry, you need this product. It's CeraVe Healing Ointment. I was using this probably about a year ago, and I ended up using up the tube that I had, and I went a little while and did not have it. And then, like I was saying earlier, I tend to get dryness this time of year around my mouth and my lips. My lips get very, very dry, and sometimes other things just don't cut it. Like the Laneige Lip Sleeping Mask. I love that stuff. It smells incredible. I still use it, but in terms of like repairing my lips, it does not get the job done like this does. This, I'm telling you, if you have dry skin somewhere and you apply a lot of this before you go to bed, it makes the biggest difference and you do not need much of it. It's a very thick product and it kind of turns into like a, almost feels like an oily consistency when you rub it in. But I'm telling you, if you have any dryness, you need this in your life. I actually heard about this from Dr. Dre here on YouTube. She is a board certified dermatologist and she does tons of skincare videos. If you are interested in skincare, you need to go follow and watch her. You'll love her. I will link her channel below, but she's the one that I originally saw talking about this and she's 100% right. This works so well. I've been going to bed and literally applying this all over my mouth, all over my lips, especially like the corners of my mouth tend to get dry in the wintertime, and this helps so, so much. So I wanted to mention this in case you're having trouble with that. I would definitely recommend this from CeraVe. All right, the next thing I wanted to share is something I've been trying out on my own for a little bit, and I cannot believe I have gone all this time and have not been using this product. You guys, the makeup eraser. I did get sent these makeup erasers, but this video is not sponsored. I got some of these makeup erasers, and I was very skeptical because it just sounds too good to be true to me. If you're not familiar with them, so basically, here's one of them here. It's a little cloth like this. They come in different sizes, and basically you dampen the cloth, get it really, really wet, wring it out, and then you use this and only this to go over your face and remove your makeup. And I am not kidding you. It works. I was skeptical too. You're probably, if you never tried it, you're probably thinking, yeah, there's no way that works. It works, I'm telling you. Literally, you get it, you wash it in the washing machine, it does something and activates the fibers. You then wring it or get it wet. I usually use pretty warm water, wring it out, go over your face with this, and I'm telling you, it removes everything. It removes face makeup, mascara, all of it. I'm not kidding. And I would not share it if it didn't work. Trust me, I'm not gonna do that. It works. Tonight when I take my makeup off, I'm gonna use this and I will insert the clip here of me removing my makeup with this. And then I usually do a test, or when I've been testing it out myself, I did a test. I went over my face with this really well and then I took a cotton pad with some Bioderma on it and went over my face again, and literally hardly anything comes off of my face. It is crazy. I was genuinely shocked when I tried this because I just didn't believe it. Although I've seen it gets really good reviews, I've never used it. You guys, this is amazing. I have a few of them here and I will be getting some more because here's two. These are the mini, I think these are considered mini sizes. And then they also come in these little like round sizes like this. These came in a pack of seven. So you get like one for every day of the week. And the greatest thing is you just throw them in your washer, wash it with your other clothes, and you're good to go. So they're reusable. You don't have to use 10,000 cotton pads because I have definitely been doing that over the years. I've been using cotton pads and, you know, they remove makeup fine, but I'm telling you, this is amazing. So basically what I do is I use one of these to get off the majority of my makeup, and then I use my cleanser and cleanse my skin because I always do a double cleanse. I never just use like one round of makeup remover and that's it. I always cleanse twice. So basically you're getting off like 90% of what's on your face with this, and then anything that's left you can get it with your cleanser. So that's how I've been using it, but I wanted to share this because this is such, I don't know how it works. I don't get it. I don't understand it, but it works. And one other thing I was going to mention is, so obviously there's two sides to it. The side with the shorter fiber, so the side without the tag, is meant to remove the makeup. And then the side that has the tag, the fibers on this side are a little bit longer. This is actually meant to exfoliate. So really what they say to do is to get it wet, wring it out, use the side with the short fibers to remove your makeup, do all of that, and then flip it over. And if you want to, use the longer fiber side to exfoliate. And that's it. They're machine washable, and I'm excited about these. I had to share it with you since I was doing this video, and I do have a code. It's Blair15. I will put it up here on the screen, and I'll leave my code below with the link as well. So if you want to use it, please do. If you don't, that's totally fine. But I wanted to share it because I've genuinely been loving these. All right, now we're going to move on to a few makeup things. The first one, you guys have seen me use this. If you've been watching my videos, you've seen this in almost every video, but I have been loving the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. In fact, there's like, I mean, there might be a tiny bit left in here, but not much. I have almost used up this whole bottle, and I honestly haven't had it for very long. I love this. It definitely has a smell to it, and I was trying to figure out what it smells like. It has cucumber listed in the ingredients, so I don't know if it's cucumber that I smell, but I love the smell of this. I'm not typically big into fragrance on my face, but for some reason I really like the smell, and I love the continuous mist. I think that's genius. It's so much easier to just press the button down one time, spray your face, instead of having to click over and over and over and over. And I also love this gives a radiant finish to your face. So if you ever apply a good bit of powder, or you just kind of want to meld everything on your face together a little bit better, this is amazing. I love this. I do think it comes in a mattifying version as well. I haven't tried that. This is just the original one, but I've been loving this. I've been using this obviously at the end of my makeup to set, but then I've also been spraying my face with this throughout applying my makeup. So you may have seen it in a few videos. I have been dotting foundation on my face and then taking a setting spray, usually this one, going over my face and then blending out my foundation. And I don't know why, but I swear it makes a difference when you do that. It's like it helps everything spread and really blend in a little bit better. I don't know, but I genuinely love this. In fact, I already bought a new one because I know I'm definitely going to always have this now that I've tried it. And it's pretty affordable. It's like, I don't know, $12, $14 maybe, somewhere around there. But I wanted to mention it because I've been using this a ton and it's pretty much gone. Okay, let's talk about what I have on my face for foundation today. And it's not a foundation, it's a concealer. And I have been talking about this a lot, so you may know what it is, but I am obsessed with this, you guys. The NYX Bear With Me Serum Concealer in the shade Vanilla. Okay, this 100% my favorite drugstore concealer I have ever tried. And I've said this before, I do not have many drugstore concealers that I really like. I just don't. I usually can't find a shade that I like, or I just don't like how it looks under my eyes. This one I like on my face as foundation and under my eyes, which makes it even better. That's what I have on today. I have this all over my face and under my eyes as concealer. And I'm telling you, this is so freaking good. I was very skeptical because sometimes when products like this kind of go viral, I'm like, okay, are they really that good? Or is it just kind of something that was hyped up and then the hype kind of dies down? Okay, this one, the hype is real. I'm telling you, if you find this in a shade that you think works for you, pick it up. I guarantee you will like this. It's hydrating. It gives, honestly, a lot more coverage than I thought it would. Today, I actually used one pump for my face and under my eyes. One pump. That's it. Like, as in one pump for my face and my under eyes, not one pump each. And I just love how it looks. I wear the shade Vanilla, and I'm telling you guys, you need to try this for sure. I've done a dedicated review on this already here on my channel that I'll link for you, but I had to mention this because I love this. Holy grail status, for real. All right, now we're gonna talk about lashes. One of my favorite things to talk about. I have two things I wanna share with you. One of them will not be a surprise because I've been talking about it constantly. But the other thing I have mentioned here and there, but I don't think I've mentioned this specific one. And I wanted to share the lash serum I've been using probably for the last like 2 months, I would say, consistently every night. And it's Nude Lash. So I got this from Nordstrom. Nordstrom sells this in a two-pack for I think it's $99, and you get two of these. That's where I got mine. I never hear anyone talking about Nude Lash, and I'm not sure if it's just an exclusive to Nordstrom product because that's the only place I've ever seen it. But this is what I use on my lashes. I was using Grande Lash. I like Grande Lash. I think it works. But I'm telling you, something about this makes my lashes even longer. If I use this every single night, my lashes look like this. Like, I don't know if you can see, my lashes are very, very long right now. I'm telling you, it's from this product. I actually got my mom this for Christmas. I got her that two-pack I was talking about from Nordstrom. The other thing I like about this is it does not irritate my lash line. That is one issue I've had with lash serums in the past. I've used Revitalash. It works. 100%, it works in terms of making your lashes grow, but I do a lot of times have irritation right at the base of my lashes when I use that, which I don't love. I just, I don't want to make my eyes red and irritated just to get long lashes. That's just not ideal, but I do not have any irritation with this. None. And it works so well. I've been using this religiously every single night, and my lashes have been looking good for quite a while now, and I'm telling you, it's from this product. So I had to mention this. This one is actually almost gone, sadly. I do think one of these tubes lasts a very long time, though, because I had this open for a while, and I just wasn't using it consistently until the last 2 months. And I'm telling you, this is good. And then the other thing I've been loving for my lashes, this you prop, well, if you watch my videos, you've seen me use this. This is my favorite mascara right now. The Rare Beauty Perfect Strokes Mascara. You guys, the combination of this mascara and that lash serum, so good. So good. This adds a ton of volume. It adds length as well, but I would definitely say it's more volume than length, but it's very, very black and it does not transfer. It does not smudge. It is so good. I have the mini one, but I am gonna buy the full size of this, which I typically don't buy. I buy them, but I don't buy a ton of high-end mascaras often. I do occasionally, but this one, when I run out of this mini, I've been using this for, I don't know, like a month and a half at this point, probably. And I love this. This I will 100% buy. If you want to try it out, I would definitely recommend the mini. That way you can at least try it and you spend, I think it's like $11 maybe instead of $20. But that has been my go-to mascara. And I mean, hopefully you can see like it works. It really works. So I wanted to mention that. And then the last thing I wanted to mention is a lip combo. I actually mentioned this about a week ago on my Instagram stories, and I wanted to share it here on YouTube. It's what I have on my lips right now. This, I just randomly did this combination like a week or, well, I guess it's been like 2 weeks ago now, and I loved it. I've been trying out a ton of different lip combos because I've been filming pretty much every day, and I'm obsessed with this combo. So it's three products. The first is the Urban Decay 24/7 Lip Liner in 1993, which is it's kind of a brown, it's like a brownie nude. This is such a good brown. It's not like intimidatingly brown. Like sometimes when I use brown lip liner, I feel like if I don't blend it really well, if you have more fair skin, sometimes I feel like it can look a little bit harsh. But this is the perfect brown. I love it so much mixed with this Charlotte Tilbury lipstick. So this is the Kissing lipstick in the shade Nude Kate. So I basically put this really just in the center of my lips. So that is it right there. It's a really light peachy nude. And I kind of just kind of dab it on in the center, mix it together with the lip liner. And then on top, I used this MAC Cream Sheen Glass in the shade Boy Bait. And it's just kind of a light milky pink. And oh my gosh, this combo I'm obsessed with. I love these three together. Something about this, I don't know, the mixture of these colors, I just really like it. It's very neutral. It goes with everything, and I've been wearing it a ton since I discovered this combo, so I wanted to share that with you as well. And that is it, you guys. That is everything that I've been using a ton and really loving. I love to do these videos every few months and just kind of share the things that I'm using that I love and that really stand out that I want to share with you. I don't do monthly favorites videos. I like to kind of save them up for a few months before I share them with you. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you're new, I hope you'll stick around and subscribe and go follow me over on Instagram at simply.blair. I will list everything below, like I said in the video. And thank you so much for being here and supporting my channel. I will see you guys tomorrow for another video. Remember, simply be you. Bye.